Hi, I'm Vikram and welcome to A Roll of Film. In this episode of Shooting With, I'm going to review a roll of film that I shot with the Zenit ET. The Zenit ET is a Soviet era camera and I have loaded on it the Helios 44-2 58mm f2 lens. This too is a Soviet era lens and an iconic lens at that. I have reviewed this lens in my previous video, and for those who have not seen that video, I'm putting a link down in the description below. Now, this particular camera is rather close to me, in the sense that this belonged to my father-in-law, and so it has a lot of sentimental value attached to it. Now, the Zenit ET has an exposure meter. Unfortunately, the exposure meter on this one is not working, so I therefore use the Sunny 16 rule. Now, those of you who are not familiar with the Sunny 16 rule, I have also done a video on that explaining the fundamentals of the Sunny 16 rule. And those who have not seen that video, I recommend that you do so. I had loaded up this camera with the Ilford Delta 100 professional film, 35mm black and white film. I'm sure you're all familiar with that film stock. Unfortunately, the exposure meter was not the only thing that was not working in this camera. I found out later, once the roll was developed, that there was a problem with the shutter too, in the sense that the shutter was misfiring, and due to this misfire, I lost about 15 to 16 shots. It was totally, the shutter just didn't open at all. So out of the balance, about 20 shots, I managed to get 11 good exposures. And under the circumstances, I thought that was pretty good. So let's now have a look at these shots. So this is the first exposure. This is a building under construction close to where I live in Bangalore. And using the Sunny 16 rule, this was around about say 3 o'clock in the afternoon. One side of the building, as you can see here, was in deep shadow, the light hitting here. And I found the scaffolding very interesting, the pattern on the scaffolding. So I took the shot, as I said before, I write down my exposures, at f11. So it was 100 ASA film, so my shutter speed was constant at 125. And using the Sony 16 rule, I used f11. I should have used f16 as per the rule actually, but I wanted to get some detail in the shadow, so I overexposed by one stop, getting an f11. So here's the image. Not bad, I think I managed to get achieve what I wanted. Unfortunately, there seems to be a slight light leak here, so you can see the slight slight darkening out here, but otherwise all in all a pretty good shot. Now these this malfunctioning shutters and a little bit of light leaks and flares and all this is these are the joys of shooting with vintage cameras. Part and parcel of the game. You never know, sometimes your best images will be a result of these flaws, so they say. Now this is a small church again next to my home, shot about say 10-15 minutes after the previous shot. And here I wanted to make it a little slightly more punchy, slightly more contrasty, and you had the spotlight, the facade of the church was spotlit with the sun. So I went for an f16 exposure as per the Sunny 16 rule, and I think and I got the shot, which is also again pretty good, not bad. The next was a grill. This is my house actually, the front of my home in Bangalore, and here too I wanted to get a slightly contrasty image, and therefore I shot it at f16, which is what the Sunny 16 tells me to do, and again pretty nice image. This is also located next to my home. I think most of the shots I got were located close by. This I shot at f11, and I got the contrasty shadows the way I wanted it, but actually I think I should prefer on hindsight that I should have probably exposed it one stop more at about f8. To get a little more detail in the shadows. I would have preferred a little more detail here. There's a painting here, and I've lost total detail in that shadow. So maybe f8 might have been a better idea. Here again, this is taken the same building, the first shot, from another angle, from a slight distance, and from the park, which is close to my house again. Took the shot through the trees, and I exposed for the building actually. Shot this at f16, and I'm very, very happy with the shot. I think, hands down, this is probably the best shot on the road. Now this here is a street in Bangalore called Church Street, and every weekend it is closed to traffic and it's taken over by street artists. It has a lot of graffiti, lovely graffiti on its walls, and this was taken again around in the afternoon. I shot it at f11, overexposing it by 1 as per the Sony 16 rule, but I still think it came out pretty nicely. I'm quite satisfied with this. It's quite nice. A little further down, again in George Street, this I took at f16. This is actually the effect I wanted, so maybe in the previous photo also I should have taken it at f16, but even then f11 did worked out pretty well. Now this is the facade of the metro station. It is the MG Road metro station, but this as seen from Church Street. We've got these lovely paintings all over its facade. And again, this was spot lit, and I overexposed it by a couple of stops. I took it at f8 because I wanted to get the detail of the painting from within the shadows, and I think it's come out pretty well. In fact, this 2 is, I think, probably one of the better shots in the road. Maybe the second or the first, almost as good as that building shot. Now this is some wildlife which I shot in Kabini. I spent a large portion of my life in Kabini working as a nature guide, naturalist. And elephants are one of my favorite subjects, and I think they look excellent in black and white. So this was taken with a 58mm lens and exposed at f11. It was around 4 o'clock in the afternoon, nice sunny day, and it was nice. Though of course I would have preferred to have slightly longer focal length. Maybe a 70-200 lens would have given me a much closer, much better shot. But at f58 also, I think it's pretty good. At 58mm, it was still a pretty good shot. This is taken at f11, ever exposed by one stop. The same elephant. From another angle, turn around, again f11, again part of him is in the shadow. I think that adds a lot of part of the animal being in the shadow, in the dark shadow. If I had taken an f8, I would have lightened that shadow, but I purposely did not, because I love that dark shadow on one side of the elephant. And just for your information, this was taken from a boat. That is one of the highlights of Kabini, is that you can do a safari by boat. Probably, I think Kabini by boat is one of my favorite ways of doing a safari. And then finally, the last shot. This was taken in the central business district of Bangalore. This was taken on a very, very dull day, overcast dull day, and I exposed this at 5.6. I was not very sure about this exposure, but I just took it at 5.6. On hindsight, I think f4 might have been a better idea, because the shadows here are extremely dark, absolutely no detail there. F4 would have pulled out some more detail in those shadows, but even then, I think pretty good image. So that's it. I got 11 shots. Usable, of course. I lost about 10-15, as I said, 15 shots due to the shutter. So 11 out of about, say, 20-21, 50% strike rate, not bad, I think, for my first throw. And I must say, I really enjoyed this shooting this Ilford Delta 100, a nice film stock. And I'm now motivated to go out and shoot a roll of black and white in my Yashica 124G. So I guess think I'll do that over the coming weekend, and once I have the results, I'd love to share them with you. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, Please like, subscribe and share. Thank you and see you next week.